Hello and welcome to my latest video. In this video, I'm going to show you how you can authorize your Facebook group to accept third-party apps. So that basically means that if you want a third-party live streaming app, so perhaps you want to put StreamYard, use StreamYard in your group, you need to firstly authorize that app to work inside your group. Another reason you might want to do it is if you're scheduling posts to your group using a third-party tool such as Hootsuite or Buffer, then you would need to authorize that app inside of your group as well. So this video is going to show you how to authorize a live streaming tool to go into your Facebook group, but you can use this procedure for any other external app that you need to authorize into your group. So my name is Anita Wong, and I'm fast becoming known as the Queen of Tech. I help you to understand how to use the tech behind the social media platforms that you use. If you like this video, please give me the thumbs up. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel. And if you have any questions about what you're about to watch, pop them in the comments below and I will answer them as soon as I can. Okay, so here I am inside my paid for Facebook group, but I haven't got my live streaming app in here and I want to put that in. So all you need to do is go to the More button on your Facebook group. Then go to Edit Group Settings. This is going to open up an admin area for you to optimize. And if you haven't optimize this area, then I do have some other Facebook group videos in this playlist that you'll be able to watch to optimize it. So as you can see, we've just scrolled down and just below the tags, there is a tool area called apps. This is where you need to add the apps that you want to use that are third party. Click on add apps. Then going to ask you for the app that you want to add in. Okay, so once that's opened, it will give you a lot of apps that are usually used by Facebook owners. If you want to just look for your own app, you can search it up the top. So I'm going to look up StreamYard, which is the live streaming app that I want to authorize. So there it is, StreamYard. So then you click on the app that you want to use, and it will ask you to give permission. So see posts and comments in your group, but not who wrote them. So we're going to click add. So now I've added StreamYard and it can be used in your group and you just click done. Don't forget that once it's there, as you can see, it's inside of my group and you can manage your apps at any time. So you can actually remove the apps at any time. So if you click on that button again, you can actually remove it. So if you stop using it for any reason or you don't want to have it inside your group, you can remove it at any time. If you want to add more apps in, then you can go ahead and add another app. So like I mentioned in the introduction, if you were using a third-party tool such as Hootsuite or Buffer, you could actually add it in there as well. So I could just put Hootsuite in here and you'll see that it will come up as an option. So that's how you add your apps in. Remember to press the save button after you've finished all your changes at the bottom of the admin area, just to make sure that Facebook has saved everything. So that's how you add a third-party app to your Facebook group. So if you ever have a problem where you're trying to use a tool inside of your Facebook group and it's not working or it won't go in, then that might be what's causing the issue. If you have any questions about this video, please don't hesitate to pop them in the comments below. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel and give me the thumbs up if you liked it.